Chapter 3, Blessings and Wood Elves. Latia.
Blessings. We will be blessed if we rest here.
Dalma. Yes, and wounds will heal better too. All the animals of the forest come here when they are injured. It is their safe haven.
Latia. How wonderful that you created this magical place for them.
Dalma. It was created to honor Lord Doradin and his party of adventurers. The benefit to the creatures of the forest is just a nice side effect. And while it will benefit anyone, no one else is welcome here. Now I agreed to show you the shrine, and you agreed to leave afterwards. It's time to go. At this, Lightmane decided it was time to talk, so he stepped forward a little.
Lightmane, so we paid you 8 silver pieces just to see it? You won't let us rest here and benefit from it?
Why not?
Dalma, that was the deal. I normally don't make deals, so you should be quite pleased that I allowed you to come here, for that was not my original intention. So I suggest you all turn around now and go back to Duran and stay there and stay out of our woods.
Latia, we will leave now. We're sorry we've upset you.
Lightmane, no, hold on.
Latia,
Lightmane, just a while ago it was you telling me to respect their wishes. Why are you doing this?
Lightmane,
because, Latia, something isn't right.
Lightmane, turning back to Dalma,
this doesn't make any sense. You were adamant that we leave, and we were going to, but then you changed your mind. Why? What's going on? Why let us see the shrine and then demand that we leave? We are no threat to you. We want to be friends. We want to help you destroy the goblins that live in this forest.
Dalma, we do not want your friendship. The goblins are our concern, not yours. We do not require any help with them, nor do we want any. You paid to see the shrine. You've seen it. Now get out of our forest, or we'll throw you out. The wood elves all reached for their bows and readied them with great ease and speed. Jack thought about casting sleep, then realized how stupid that would be, and did nothing instead.
Latia, please do not attack us. We will leave. We are sorry we've upset you.
Lightmane, fine, we'll leave. But you're not telling us something, and you know we mean you no harm. We could be allies, but you refuse. I'm guessing out of stubbornness more than anything else, or maybe it's foolishness or arrogance that you suffer from.
Dalma did not like those last words from Lightmane and glared at him.
Latia, Lightmane, that's enough. Let's go. As the party started to walk away, the wind started swirling, and leaves were caught up in the air and swirled around all of them.
Latia, what's going on?
Lightmane, no clue.
Dalma yelled at the party. What are you doing? Stop this! Stop it now!
Latia, you think we're doing this? We're not doing anything. We're just trying to leave.
The wind picked up, and more leaves swirled all around the party and the wood elves. A moment later, and they all fell to the ground and just laid there silently.
Shinfia opened her eyes. She looked around and saw everyone lying on the ground, but now they all started to awaken as well.
Shinfia, what happened?
Teneth, I believe we were all knocked unconscious or put to sleep or something. Not sure, really, but I'm feeling pretty good. How about you?
Shinfia, yes, I feel pretty good too. What's going on?
As everyone started to get to their feet, Dalma spoke.
It was the shrine. It did this. It was the shrine that spoke to me back there. You all were chosen, as were all of us, apparently.
Latia, chosen? What do you mean?
Dalma, when we first met, I heard a voice. It said to let you see the shrine and to trust it. I did not understand, but then, all of a sudden, I felt calm and somehow knew that it was telling me the truth and that I could trust it, so I did. Which is why I changed my mind and brought you here. And now we have all received the blessing.
Teneth, blessing? Do you mean like the bless spell that us clerics can cast?
Dalma, yes, but more powerful than your bless spell. It could last for days, weeks even. When we told you to leave, I guess it had no choice but to knock us all out. I'm guessing we've slept for quite a few hours. That's usually what happens.
Jack, looking up at the sky. Well, judging by the light of day, that sounds about right. It'll be dark soon. We should probably head back to Duran. We'll probably have to pay to stay at the inn now since we don't work for anyone anymore. No more room and board.
Dalma, you can stay with us tonight.
The shocked look on everyone's face wasn't surprising, except that all the Wood Elves looked shocked too.
Wood Elf, Dalma, what are you doing?
Dalma, Trent, you saw what happened. The shrine chose them. We can't ignore that.
Another Wood Elf.
But no one is allowed in our camps. They will not allow this.
Dalma, Trina, I understand your concern, but once they hear what happened, they will allow it.
We must let them stay in our camp tonight.
We must.
Jack,
Trent and Trina? Cute. Are you two a couple?
Trent, Trina is my mate, and I am hers. Do you have someone? The half-elf, perhaps.
Latia,
excuse me?
Jack, starting to laugh nervously.
No. We're just friends. Good friends. Companions. I mean, friends. Just friends.
Lightmane,
we are all good friends. Fate brought us all together, and today has confirmed that even more. We would be very honored to spend the night with you and your people, and, looking at Dalma, I apologize for angering you earlier.
Dalma, smiling ever so slightly.
Apology accepted. We don't associate with non-wood elves, but this will be an exception. Here is your money back. We don't need it, but we know you do, which is why we charged you. But in light of what happened, I think you should have it all back. Let us travel to our camp now. It isn't far.
As they walked, the party tried their best to express their appreciation to the wood elves, but Dalma didn't seem all that interested.
Dalma, I understand your desire to be friends with us, but it's not going to happen.
However, you may now travel to the shrine whenever you want, provided that you only travel on the trail and go back to Duran afterwards. The roads and the trail are all you're allowed to travel on. This trip to our camp is a one-time thing. Tomorrow, we will escort you to the road of your choosing and part ways. I don't know why or how the shrine chose you. I had no idea it could speak, let alone make choices. I assumed it only responded to those who came to rest or worship.
Latia,
so you do not know how or why this happened to all of us?
Dalma, no clue, but it is clear that we must allow you to go there whenever you want, just as we allowed Dorden and his party. You are the only others who have this arrangement.
Latia was about to speak, but Dalma beat her to it.
Dalma, here we are. Welcome to our camp.
The party was confused. There was nothing but forest everywhere they looked.
Nightwind, this is your camp?
Dalma,
the dwarf speaks, she said, showing no emotion.
Nightwind hesitated.
Yes, well, dwarves and elves don't often get along very well, so I thought it best to stay silent. Until now, that is.
Dalma, I see. No, this isn't our camp. She pointed up into the trees.
That is our camp.
Jack,
where? I just see trees.
Lightmane,
oh my.
Jack, look higher.
Jack, higher?
Up maybe 100 feet or more, small platforms and bridges finally came into Jack's view. From their vantage point, what they were looking at didn't seem possible. How could such things be built so high up, and how are they going to get up there without falling and killing themselves?
Jack, you want us to go up there?
How? We can't possibly, and if we fall, we're dead. There's no way we can do this.
Dalma, you will be fine,
Jack.
No one will fall or hurt themselves. I give you my word.
On the other side of a tree was a rope ladder which they crawled into. It protected them on all sides as they climbed. A harness was attached to each of them, which helped them climb. The wood elves needed no such assistance. They pulled themselves up with vines that hung everywhere, but were barely seen as they blended in with the forest when they weren't moving.
Tenneth, do you think this is why some say that the forests in Forestera are magical?
Phileas,
could be. This is amazing. We are perfectly strapped in, and climbing up is easy. This is incredible.
Jack,
yes, But how do we avoid falling when we're up there?
Dalma, looking at Latia. Does he always worry like this?
Latia, smiling. Jack has always been cautious, but he's also our treasurer. That means you can trust him. He's as honest as the day is long.
Well, we're all on, Dalma. I understood what you meant, but do not worry, for no wood elf is untrustworthy. We don't steal from each other like you all do in your villages.
Latia, most of us don't steal either.
Dalma, most, perhaps, but some do, and some of you murder and abuse each other. You won't see any of that here. We are all one with the forest in every way, and ridding the forest of goblins is our sacred duty, which is why you are not welcome to assist us. If you wish to go fight goblins on your own, that's up to you. But since you're not allowed to travel in our forest, I don't think I need to say any more.
Latia.
But why not? Have we not proven that you can trust us?
Dalma.
All you have proven is that the shrine chose for you to experience its power and blessings. But even if we did trust you, you still would not be allowed in our forest. You are being allowed to stay the night in our camp so that the others will know who you are, and because I believe it is the right thing to do, seeing your current financial situation.
Belfin.
So all the wood elves live up here?
Dalma.
Speaking of those who steal for a living, Belfin, as well as Phileas, trying to look innocent.
Hey, we don't steal. Well, unless we have to. It's a skill, but we're good people. We help others and work for the betterment of all.
Phileas.
Yes, what Belfin said. I'm not a thief. I'm a rogue. There's a difference.
Latia.
Guys, a little less talk, a little more patience and understanding, maybe?
Dalma. Interesting that you refer to yourselves as rogues and not thieves, for every wood elf is a rogue, along with other skills that we possess. But we've seen how you rogues work. We've observed your kind for many generations. If you so much as even think about stealing something in our camp, you will deeply regret you ever saw us. But to your question, no. We are one camp of many. But for every one of us, there's probably 4 to 5 goblins, if not more.
Phileas.
4 to 5? For every one of you, if not more? It sure sounds like you could use some help.
Dalma.
We need no help. Welcome to our camp. I will show you where you will sleep.
No one had a clue what was holding this camp up in the air. Looking down, though, it was hard to see through to the ground. Tree branches crossed paths everywhere, and when they walked across a rope bridge, it was as though something was holding on to them, assisting them as they walked. There were rooms everywhere that seemed to just sit on a tree branch somehow, and when they went inside, it felt as solid as any building, and yet everything moved back and forth slowly, swaying in the trees. Everything about this place felt magical. Many wood elves looked shocked to see the party, but Dalma spoke to them, and just like that, everything was fine.
Dalma,
these have been to the shrine. The shrine chose them. We were all knocked unconscious and slept there, all of us, and when we awoke, we had all received its blessing. I do not know why this happened, but it happened. So I brought them here for the night, for their protection, and also so you'd know who they are, for we have no choice now but to allow them to travel to the shrine whenever they wish. They know the rules, and they understand.
The wood elves seemed to all be looking them over, studying them almost, and then they all walked away. Others came and did the same. This went on for a little while, before Dalma finally took them to the room where they would sleep.
Latia,
may we come out and sit and talk with some of you before setting in for the night?
Dalma,
you may not. Eat your rations and get your sleep, and in the morning we will take you to the trail or to a road, and then we will depart from you.
Dalma then turned to walk out.
Latia, Dalma, wait. I want us to be friends. I want to get to know you and you us. We are all very grateful for your hospitality and for all that happened today. We know now that you are good people and not our enemies or dangerous.
Dalma,
I assure you, Latia, we're dangerous.
were very dangerous, and that's the way it's going to stay. I understand why you want to be friends with us, but that's just not going to happen, so quit trying. We are here because the forest is here. We despise your world and your ways. We are nothing like you, and you are nothing like us. So get used to that, and we'll all just coexist like we do with Doradin. As Dalma walked away, Lightmane got up and stood by Latia. Lightmane, they're different, all right. But she has no clue how much alike we are than different. Latia, tell me about it. As they sat down to eat their rations, talk of tomorrow naturally came up. Nightwind,
well, shall we head towards the moat house tomorrow, or the keep, or what?
Belfin, either is fine with me, but I sure wish we had some tastier food to eat. I'm not used to eating iron rations. My stomach is not... Oh, wait. My stomach feels fine. I guess that blessing heals more than just wounds.
Belfin had a big smile on his face as he started eating his rations. Everyone agreed. The rations actually tasted quite good.
Nightwind, who needs roast duck when you've got such tasty morsels? Why doesn't your blessed spell do this?
Tenneth, oh, funny. Yeah, tomorrow I'll start working on a blessed spell that lasts for days and heals your wounds and makes your food taste good. Sure thing. I'll get right on that.
Latia, well, I want to know what the rest of that sign was talking about. What else did it say?
Jack, something about laying your gift in the chest if you need something else. No clue what that means, but next time we're there, let's cast Comprehend Languages and write it down. Too bad none of us know how to speak or read Wood Elf.
Shinfia,
let's just do that first thing tomorrow morning, and then go to Duran and head for the moat house, unless you'd rather go to the keep. I'm good either way.
Lightmane, so am I. I think we all are. Let's just go to the moat house, since it's closer, and good idea about writing down what that sign says. I'll just cast my Detect Magic spell now and memorize Comprehend Languages. Too bad we don't have any item to cast Detect Magic on.
Jack, why don't you just cast it on the room, and I'll step outside and cast mine and see what happens.
Why not?
Lightmane, sure. Good idea. Can't hurt. Jack stepped outside and cast his spell.
Okay, then. Everything's magical. Alteration magic, abjuration, conjuration, enchantment. What the heck? I've never had a detect magic spell detect multiple spheres of magic all at once. Is the entire place magical?
Lightmane, same with the room. It's all magical, apparently. My best guess is that this camp of theirs was created using some very powerful magic. Not sure what else would explain it.
Latia, well, this has been quite a day, hasn't it? When I said I wanted to go join an adventuring party to go adventuring, I kind of meant explore caves, fight monsters, find treasure, you know, that kind of stuff. But I'm not complaining. This has been one amazing day. Everyone agreed, and soon they all set in for the night. The room and their bedding was warm and very comfortable, and in no time at all, they had all fallen asleep. That night was the best sleep any of them had ever had. Was it the magic of the camp? Was it the blessing they had all received? Maybe it was both, but whatever it was, when they woke up the next morning, they all felt perfectly rested and cleansed throughout their entire body. Each of them was filled with anticipation and excitement for what the new day would hold.
Sheila. So what are you planning on doing today?
Bale. Same thing I always do. Pour through all these books you have in search of answers.
Sheila. You do realize that if an answer was in there, that I'd already know it, right?
Bale. Yes, of course, but I'm not going to sit around here and do nothing all day, so I might as well keep reading and try to acquire as much knowledge as you have.
By the way, don't you have things that you have to attend to? You're usually out and about by this time, doing whatever it is that you do. What's going on? Are you taking a day off?
Sheila.
Funny, funny. I do what I want to do. But you already knew that.
Bale. Yes. Must be nice to be completely free like that.
Weird, though. I would have thought you'd be swamped every moment, seeing who and what you are.
Sheila.
Oh, I was. In the beginning.
But over time, you learn how to delegate things to others. Like you, for example. You've been a wonderful help for me, straightening my study and cleaning my place and cooking and cleaning, mopping the floor, playing fetch, bail. Yes. Wait, what? Fetch. Why do I enjoy that so much? It's so unbecoming. Bale shook his head in disgust. Sheila, well, I think it's fun. I sure do love having someone to throw a ball with. If only you could throw it back. Bale, well, I promise that as soon as I'm able to, I'll put playing catch with you at the top of my to-do list. Sheila, yay! But when that happens, I'm so going to get a dog. Bale sighed again and put his paws on his head and struggled to adjust his glasses and went back to reading.